thank you, ma'am, for taking up your precious time for us. I would also like to welcome our SVP of Biotechnology, Dr. Ramachandran. Thank you, sir, for being here. And I would like Nausicaa to just give you a little bit brief about what this workshop is going to be.
Captain
Nair
and today's workshop on clinical research and pharmacovigilance, conducted by a master research, will provide you with an insight on various topics such as clinical research introduction, phases of clinical trials, drug discovery and development, nanomedicine and drug delivery, regulatory affairs, biostatistics, and clinical data management. So over the years, the master research has trained thousands of students of various life sciences domains and placed these students into the fastest growing industry of clinical research and pharmacovigilance. I hope this workshop will enlighten you in the field of clinical research. So without further ado, I would like to invite Ms. Alameru to begin the presentation.
What exactly we do. One thing was, Master Research, like, we are a global brand in this particular industry, in clinical research and pharmacovigilance. And last time we had a session in Dubai, 2019, we had a first debut in multiple countries we did. And I think right now, in 2020 and 2021, clinical research needs no introduction, right? All of us are away. At least when we we've been doing this for a decade of time. So in a lot of colleges in Dubai and also with multiple countries, in fact, in Malaysia. And it just so happened 2020 and 2021, even a common man knew what clinical research was all about. So how do we get the vaccines? Does it happen without a trial? So everybody knew what, how we tested and why it took a long time. Take a few moments so that you'll understand the global market that is available. By College of Pharmacy. This is your own college, Bits Pilani. Your seniors, 2019 we had this, Dubai College of Pharmacy. She was at Manipal. All of them were biotech. So you will see a mixture of this is pharmacy, you will see MBBS, BDS, so different colleges. So one thing you will understand, it's not just for a pharmaceutical degree, just for pharmacovigilance and clinical trials. Pharma student. It's also open for pharma biotech students. So we had it with Malaysia universities. Faster. Session faster. In Malaysia. It was an AIIMS university. West. In Bangkok, Eastern Asia University. So what is one thing which is common in for a biotech to life science students, to pharma students, to BDS, MBBS? How does one industry include all the set of life science students are into this one industry, and there's a very huge demand? Why would you think even a MBBS or an MD pharmacology student tries to enter into clinical research? Can anyone tell me, as we keep going through the video, can anyone tell me why is it this one industry, clinical research, pharmacovigilance, which is being the most accommodative industry for even doctors and MDs, after years of clinical practice, they move into clinical research? What is the reason? There could be few reasons why this doctor or practicing profession, what does clinical research involve? Basically, what is I think it would be finding out some new disease or anything, any disorder that's been happening, and trying to find a way to cure it.
Okay.
That is what I feel it should be.
Okay. But how does it? Is it a pharmaceutical deal? So just want to check a particular drug, or how does the entire market comes? Like a very typical example you can take up is like how long did it take from the vaccine being found to be coming into the market? Approximately. We know that COVID vaccine came, right? The vaccine was found. And we were all waiting. When will the vaccine be used for people? These are all India, different locations in India. Pune, Mumbai, Bangalore. This is the Chennai office. So we have multiple campus interviews happening. So it's just a glimpse when you see the batches and batches of students we have been doing for a decade, and it's been lakhs of students that we have covered all these years. And all these people get a job into this clinical research industry. And why would being just a biotech R&D or a pharma R&D or a QA, QC, all these the conventional traditional profiles, are some of the television shows. We have a lot of educational programs in clinical research.